think we can start. And just in order to know what are we going to do, I will introduce in even not a couple of minutes, because the main idea of the talk is not that me is speaking, but is that you all are speaking. And I will tell you something like nothing. I will just give you some rules to discuss something that is not up to me, but up to you. So my main job is to do exactly nothing. And I enjoy it. Well. My name is Guido Giacomo Gattai. I studied mainly in Florence and after in Paris. And I will play with you this kind of game, because in my opinion is quite a kind of game that is born in Paris in 1992 by Marc Soutine, that was a practitioner philosopher, I'd say, that started just going in this cafe in Place de la Bastille that had named Café d'Ophel. And now in Paris we have something like 20, 30 philosophical cafe each and every Sunday morning. Now, Sunday morning in Poland, people don't go to the philosophical cafe, so we do it in some other period, in some other time, because Sunday morning, of course, is not a good time. It depends by the nation, you know? Yeah. Even in Italy, if you do something like that, it's Sunday morning, people just have a day after, so they don't do, they don't feel like going to the philosophical cafe. But well, the main idea from Marc Soutine was just to discuss, to help people to discuss together about some issue that was really important for those people. Okay, so it was just a way to let people discuss together with some rules. Why some written rules? Because if you discuss without any kind of rules, you just have a bunch of people discussing together. Normally there is always the same one, the more charismatic or powerful, let's say, that is able to impose himself on the others, okay? And so everybody must be careful to be the most powerful one, and the discussion is not a lot about the issue, but more about who is ruling, who is the better one, okay? It's kind of a little social fight that we have each and every day to demonstrate that we are the dominant human being in the room. So, the idea of the philosophical cafe is not to be the better one, it's just to discuss together. So, having some rule give us some really, really useful and interesting chance. For example, we learn to listen to each other. Because in a normal discussion, we don't listen to each other a lot. We normally wait for the right moment to jump and start talking, okay? In a philosophical cafe, you don't have to do that, because you have some rules, you have your turn. So you can keep quiet, you will have the way to speak, and nobody will interrupt you. So you can keep calm and relax. And the second thing is that normally when we talk, we just keep attention to how much I will be able to talk and to fascinate the others. Okay? In this case, in the philosophical cafe, we totally don't have nothing like that. Because as you have your turn and your time, simply you say what you want to say. And the main attention is about to not repeat you. Because otherwise, of course, if you start taking a lot of time just to repeat 3 or 4 times the same concept, you see that all the people around you get bored. Because in a normal conversation, if you are boring somebody, just go away. Either he cannot run away, he has to listen to you. So you will really focus in not get people bored. And even that is really curious, because you will see how much, well, for me, it was really incredible to discover how much I repeat myself in normal life. Normally, I'm never enough sure that I say what I wanted to say. I just start to say it again in another shape, in another form, just to be sure that the people around me will really understood what I meant. And normally people are smarter than we think, so they understand it the first time and they just wait for you to finish for the other times. So, I have here just 3 points, and I started from the third one, and I will finish the third one telling you that rules give even freedom, because when you don't have rules, you always have to fight for your life, let's say. In a discussion, of course, you don't fight for your life, but you fight legally. So you don't have the freedom to express really something that is really in your mind. With rules, you have this chance, because you have your moment to do it, so no problem. The other points are briefer. The first time, the first point is that philosophical cafe is useful to meet each other, because in a normal meeting, if we are 10, we normally speak with two persons. There is this kind of rule of 10%. An average people in an average meeting just speak with 10% of the people attending the meeting, okay? In a philosophical cafe, everybody speaks with everybody. So you will really meet everybody else in the room, because there is no other way than let everybody speak and listen to everybody. And the last point is confronting, that is subsumable in the other points. So, of course, in meeting each other, I confront myself, and that's not something that we really do in normal life. Well, it depends, because of course it's up to you. Maybe some of you confront yourself with the others each and every day. But it's not something that is obviously done in normal life, let's see. Okay? Just maybe you do it, but there are a lot of people that doesn't. We will start with you giving me some arguments, some topics, some issues, some arguments that you want to discuss. So you just raise your hand and give me the title of the argument. After, don't try to explain your argument now, because after I will write down your name and the name of the topic that you want to discuss with us, and I will ask you to explain it to everybody. So now just please give me the title. For example, law, emptiness, silence, or no matter what else. Just the title. After, you will explain what you really mean with that word, okay? But of course, before to start, I'm just asking you to give us your name and nationality, just to know who I'm dealing with. And I start, I'm Guido from, yeah, Florence.
Okay, my name is Luciana Sinevich, and I come from Warsaw, Poland.
Okay, Mariana.
Magdalena. Yes.
My name is Gula, I come from Warsaw.
My name is Karol, I live in Warsaw.
I also live in Warsaw, my name is Renata.
Aleksandra,
okay, I'm all from Warsaw, today, and I'm Magdalena.
It's quite incredible, because normally we also, half of the people are from another nationality. Because Polish people go to other kind of meetings, and the English ones are for strangers. So, okay. It's very sorry that I don't speak Polish, because this time the news is just for me. Okay. Who has some arguments for us? The game not like that. Sorry.
But it's very similar.
Yeah, it's of course, after the main idea is just to make a choice.
Yeah.
But after, during the discussion, of course, we can even discuss the others and just.
Maybe about colors of light?
Colors
of light.
Colors of light or life?
Life.
Life. And the name wasn't good, I have a horrible memory.
If.
Okay, I think about women position in different cultures.
We're not writing 10, so let's say we're searching for other two arguments after we will start. If you have other improvements, if you just want to choose between, those, you can just go on for those. Do you want to give us your idea or not? Because Because if you don't vote, you're not forced to give us out in your marriage.
I think that marriage makes sense.
Okay.
This is my key message. But I would like to hear your opinion about it.
Do we have another question? Because normally we take a couple of questions for every topic, okay? So if somebody else has a question.
So the thing is connected with culture, because we are in Poland, it's easier to for us or normal for us to be married, or it's simply depends only on people and it's not connected with culture at all.
No, I think it is connected with culture. Definitely it's connected with culture, but I mean, as Europeans we are more or less, our roots are from the same culture, from the same continent, but I still think that it's not the 100% culture and tradition, but it's something that's like, depends on character, or how we are, how our parents raised us, and yeah, from many things.
Okay. Carl, love and passion.
Yes, I've chosen this topic because I think this is interesting. What can I say about it? Love and passion, I think, is interconnected. Love. There is a lot of love in the world, but not only. Opposite to the love, there is a lot of other feelings, like opponent to the love. Yes. And I would like to talk about what is the most important to love the family, to love friends, to love colleagues. Yes, because many people go towards only money, think about a life which is connected to the is connected with being rich only. Not thinking about feelings. I didn't think about this before, but in our conversation, I think you will have more. Things. Because this topic is very huge and there will be a lot of discussion.
Somebody
now I have that's all.
Do somebody have a question?
I have a question. Do you think that money cannot give you passion?
Yes, I think money drives you, and we are dependent on money, yes.
But if we won't be completely dependent, yes, so if money would not exist, do you think that we would have more place for passion or not? I mean, like, this is the thing that makes us living, our living possible, like we have to pay rent, we have to, I don't know, buy a car to go from place A to B. But do you think that if, for example, you have completely no limits about money, you wouldn't have to care about that? Wouldn't you be more free to create your passion so that this money would actually give you the possibility to realize and to fulfill your passion? Or is this topic more like...
Let's try to give short questions,
okay.
Because otherwise it's going to be complicated for the hour.
Okay,
first. No, no. You want to finish your question? Finish it. Just.
No, it was like maybe not repeating, but explaining more what I meant. Well, this first question is that does the money, if the money can give you a passion or not? Yes. So.
I think people like to be bonded to things, forced by other things like money, like my boss, like because if they don't have a must, yes, must. They are tired, they are not easy to make just for themselves. If they are forced by money, by other things, they make something, they go forward, yes. It's difficult for people to create something just because they see something and they want to create something. I think money makes such a thing.
Do we have another question?
Yeah, I have a question, short question. But the topic, the discussion would be more about passion, love as a feeling. Is it the human being does need it or not? Or is it in direction material world and let's say this kind of spiritual world? What is your idea about the discussion?
Here is comparison between money and happiness. There is not as much passion as a positive topic. Mm-hmm. I think we can change it to this topic. I think about passion. You asked about passion. Yeah.
No, I combined those two. Passion love as something that every human feels and money. I mean, those two things are. I mean, can I talk in many ways about the money? I think you answered my question.
Okay. Mark. Partnership relationship.
Yes, I was referring to late discussion in Poland and about our freedom and how much the government should state about that. However, I don't want to talk about politics about this topic. I don't want to talk about religious aspect of this life. I would like more to talk about the tolerance and if we are like we are, and I'm not asking you if you're hetero or homosexual, but if you can accept that other people have different point of view, different needs, and if we should help everyone to have the same rights. Yes, so this is actually the main idea of my topic, my subject that I propose.
Do somebody have some questions? Your explanation were too perfect.
Sorry for that.
Okay. Now I have a question. How about you? E, colors of life.
Yeah. It's a brunette. I don't know. We see each other first time. So I don't know your characters. I don't know nothing about your life. Why I said the color of lives, because for each of us, color means quite different. For example, red, those two paintings has something red, and the red for each of us is. It means quite different, I think. So, I would like to ask you of sense of such meanings. When we don't know each other, when we have quite different points of view, or for everything, I think, because we had about love, passion. We had about colors, and each of us understand it and try to explain for yourself. I believe in different way. So, what is the sense of discussion when we? Don't see travel to solve, but only discuss about something, about tolerance, for example. Because we have to find, even if we have different ways for understanding something, we can agree for something when we fight of travel of the nature of space. So now when we sit together and try to push some subject. Don't you have the impression that it is very difficult because this is for nothing?
Are you explaining to us why you want to talk about the colors of life or not?
Because this is the color of life. Because each of
yes
us
or no?
Has different.
Are you explaining to us why you want to discuss about the color of life? Yes or no?
Yes, I think that boosts my explanation.
Okay. Do somebody understood why she wants to discuss about colors of life? Raise your hand. So please explain to me because I was not seeing the point. Excuse me, really.
How I understood what you've said, that for each of us, we are very much different. We don't know each other. And for example, tolerance or marriage or love and passion, just to determine the subject is very hard. And it's very hard to understand what we're going to talk about if we even choose the subject.
Yeah. But do you see that?
The color, she started with the color red. For me, color red is sex, passion.
Okay.
Maybe for you it's Red Bull or whatever. And just
mix it. Black.
And on the color, she wanted, of course, correctly, but
black.
That for even a stupid color, sorry, can mean for us a very, very much different thing.
Okay.
We can even talk about color red in this meeting.
Yeah. And can we reach an agreement about color red? Yes or no?
But, okay.
So, excuse me. Can we reach an agreement about color red? Yes or no? Yes or
this
no?
Is not, this is not the subject of agreement.
Yeah, I'm just.
This is.
I have to understand this point. And after a call, because I will let you finish. Just, I would like to know if you think that we can reach an agreement about the color red. For example, just for example.
If we have
more
purpose, to discuss about it, that all of us will be understand color red.
Okay, so
in the same way.
So it's possible.
It's not makes sense, but
just
for what? For what reason?
I think she wanted to tell us, for example, red color, we see in this color in different ways.
Yeah, I know. But the point is that you are seeing that, you are saying that in this kind of meeting is pointless because we cannot reach an agreement about something. And we can.
So no. No, you do not.
But and the more problematic point, it was another one, it was that you started telling us that you want to discuss about the colors of life, and we had just one person understanding exactly why. So can you please explain us another time why you want to discuss about the colors of life? Because I was not understanding it, and
I understood that also.
Okay, now we have one and two persons, and me, I'm in the middle. Before it was, I was not understanding. Now, I wasn't, and I understood a little. But please go on.
So, sorry, can I just ask a question about the room of
yeah.
this meeting? Do we need to reach an agreement on anything?
No.
We are here for
no,
just
no, no, we don't need it. Just no, no, no.
For listening to other opinions, right?
Of course, but if we want to reach an agreement, it's possible. It's not forceful like that. If we don't want to reach an agreement, okay. But if we want, it's just up to the group.
Okay. And up to the topic.
Of course. Yes. So.
I think that the reason of such meetings should be for when we have to discuss some subject, and this will be interesting for all of us. I don't know, mountains, sea, or something like that. And each of us will be interested in such subject, and maybe by the by this subject, we have maybe have some trouble to solve. I would like to speak about the tolerance, for example, and when we can agree all that the meaning of tolerance for us. It makes something physical. It means that that we discuss something, that we agree for something, makes something good for people. It's okay, because this is the reason of such meaning. But that when we discuss about marriage, love, passion, it doesn't make sense, because it exists. Each of us know about it, and each of us understand it in other way. But it's good, because we are people, we are different.
Yeah, but excuse me, you're talking against our topic, not in favor of your topic.
No.
I need you to talk in favor of your topic.
Are you talking about Socrates?
Yeah, I wanted something about him.
Yeah,
I remember exactly about
him. You are professionalized. I'm an engineer, I have a technical degree, But when you found someone who can discuss with you about that, what you, it's really interesting for you and the other persons. It makes sense, but when it is out of interest, out of understanding, I think that this point doesn't make sense. And this is also the color of life, because each of us is a different color of the life.
Okay. Does somebody else have a question?
Okay.
You have a question?
For you, like colorful life when you can share your color with the others and hear the other arguments, other point of views about the same color, about, for example, red, as you said at the beginning. It's for me, it is interesting that, as Ula said, for her it's sex, for somebody else it's. I don't know, a bull or a fight for me is like a devil, and it doesn't mean for me important what it is, but it's interesting how other people can see it, and I can, through such arguments, understand better the world and this whole color of this world. So, do you think it's not interesting for you to share the colors of life in this way?
No, the reason that I'm very interested in the opinion of other people is that I'm here. And maybe when we met each other next time, it will be much more interesting. Because we, after this meeting, we know about each other. But sharing of that, what do you think, for example, about Fred? For me, it's very helpful because it makes my talk of you much more bigger than before that when I have your opinion. So it is the sense of sharing of other points of view, but we have to, I think that during certain things we have to keep some subject who will be not very difficult for each of us, but each of us has own opinion, and discussion. In my opinion, each discussion has to have some sense and have to have some effect for future. Because without that, we sit together with some hello. What do you think about marriage? What do you think about that? And come home and nothing happened. No? So it doesn't make sense when you can't have a real reason for discussion.
Let's see if something happens or not. Does somebody else have a question?
I have a question, but it will be short. Question and close question. I would like to know, not specifying which kind of life I'm asking about. If I ask you black or white, what would you say?
It depends on that, what, how close I know you, which, what I would like to share from my life, from my experience of my life, how much I would like to share with you, because when is try to better watch the colors I'm wearing now, and I like those two colors very much, and this is enough. But for example, if you become my friend, maybe I tell you what was happening in my life, and what was right and what was bad. Much more later, and in another situation, and it also will be left and right.
Do you have some problems with direct questions?
I don't think so, because
yes,
I don't
know. So, no. Okay.
But
so if I ask you black or white, what do you answer?
If we
black or white?
I don't choose black or white because also black and white is good for me, depends on the situation.
So it really depends. But I was actually trying to ask about the feeling, yeah? So the first intuition thing, and this is why you think the question was short, close, because okay. It's for longer discussion, but yeah,
oh.
It wasn't my point. Thanks.
Manga. Yeah. Woman position in different cultures.
Yeah, I'm thinking about it maybe not a long time, but I have a lot of friends from other countries, and last time I spent a meeting. I have a meeting with someone from Sudan. From Arabic culture, and I felt quite strange when I got money to buy this person, this guy, coffee. And it's impossible that the guy comes to me and tell me simply, do it for me, make it for me, be my servant in some way. And I lived in Germany longer, and the same situation, the other situation, it was I used to, when I go with my friends, and they are male friends, they are invited me and pay for coffee or something like that. When I was in Germany, I paid for my boyfriend all the time. And yeah, such situations are really interesting for me, and I'm thinking how should I behave myself in the other cultures? I should adopt these cultures, or I should be like I am in Poland and be afraid?
Do somebody have some question?
Maybe the question and the short comment, because I'm really interested in cross-cultural differences, and you mentioned the few of them there may reap some things and just for us to discover in different colors, you know, of the different nations. And my question is whether or not to travel to the East, because actually you mentioned Sudan and Germany, and do you have any experiences related to Eastern Europe or Russia, maybe North, European countries?
I have a little bit, but not so much. I wasn't in Russia. And
cultural differences that I can tell only about Germany, when I was longer, about Switzerland, Swiss people with whom I worked.
So, so what was difficult when it comes to your study in Germany? That you had to pay for your friends or your boyfriend? Was it difficult?
Yeah, because it's unisex. It's that in Germany, it's like unisex. We are not better or worse, maybe not in this way, but as a woman, you should be do the same what the men do. When you go through the doors, it's nobody who let you be.
Okay, I understood that you had to pay for your boyfriend, and I don't know if you actually meant that, because maybe you had to pay for yourself.
No, for him as well.
For him as well.
But it is like accidentally, like. Or the woman, like one time you pay, the second time you pay, or it's like that that you're a woman and you pay all the time?
It was mostly so that everyone should pay for him or herself. But for me it was not natural that we are together and we have everyone of us have to pay our pocket.
Okay.
And that's why I paid.
How did you pay?
Come on, you propose it. You have to defend.
Well, if you want to sit here. today, I mean, modern slaves of corporation, working for corporation, big companies, and kind of adjusting to those culture of corporation. Can we define us as slaves, modern slaves, or isn't it true? Is it the right way that the world is, or the modern world is going in this direction? This is more or less the sense of my thoughts.
Somebody have a question?
Do you think,
no questions
are fine. No, okay. Do you think that working for a corporation can shape us?
I think so. I think I was working myself for a short time for a corporation, and from my own experience I know that the half of people starting after finishing studying, they are shaped by corporation, and the half cannot adjust, and they are leaving the corporation. I think really it depends on the individual. So I think this is also an interesting issue, like what happens in corporation, why do people leave even if they have a mantra, or why do people stay, and what happens with them afterwards?
Somebody answer a question?
Excuse me, but two questions we have to
say. Yeah, sure.
Do you think there is a big difference between corporation and small company?
Oh yes, I do.
Why?
This is a very, like, I was working as well for a very small companies, and the corporation gives you pressure. I mean, it feels you like if you are in a big herd of sheep, let's say. And I don't know, I haven't been studying psychology. I am an economist. And I think if you are kind of moving just in a society of people from corporation, you are kind of brainwashed. And the small company doesn't happen. It's rather a family business. Become rather a family business for you, even if you are not belonging to this family, like member, but it's still a different world. Different rules of play, different hierarchical arrangements. I mean, this is my point of view.
But you think about relations in the company?
Yes,
about family,
as well, about everything, relations between co-workers, relations between you and boss, relations to other companies as you behave on business meetings and everything. It depends. I mean, it influences actually all your private life.
But I think if you want
less limits for the
if you want to achieve something, you have to.
Excuse me, we have just two questions, and after, if we vote for these topics, we'll discuss this one. All of it happens.
I'm so colored currently. Okay, happiness. Happiness is a beautiful subject, a beautiful topic from cross-cultural point of view, and from personal point of view. So I hope for conversations, debates, or debate maybe. How can we? How do you? How we define happiness? Do you have solutions and strategies maybe how to gain it? We are searching for our small happinesses maybe. How we do it? How we experience the lack of happiness in our lives? So that's how I see it, and that's how I would like to talk about happiness. And also, I can give you some scientific definition of it. We know from psychology a lot of models of it, and you can also discuss.
Somebody have a question? We have a compliment, but do we have any questions?
It's always nice to have some compliments.
Satisfactions with every everyday life.
has a purpose, that her purpose is valuable, and I satisfy it for the group every day. We also can consider the religion in relation to happiness, because it can also play a role for some of us. God and it's really complex, and I think it's fun because it's an art in the process, probably the long one to search for it. And to be aware of the fact that we are.
Okay, so now normally we take 10 minutes of pause before to pause and discuss the argument. We, of course, we don't have Ula for the last one, or we have Ula?
We have Ula.
We have Ula, wow, finally.
I'm very sorry because I kind of was planning something else for tonight as well.
Yes.
To be or to have?
To be or to have. Well, this is, I think, issue. I mean, for me, this issue is an issue that I'm kind of fighting almost every day with struggling for to be or to have. I mean, to be, what does it mean for us to be, to be ourselves, or to have, are we, there's more of us, if we have more, like we talked already about passion and money, or do we feel a kind of richer person when we do not have material? It's about material world. Do we like it, or we feel better when we have more, or we feel worse when we don't have anything, but like we think about other values. It's a very broad issue, it's a very broad topic. There are books written on it by many modern and archaic philosophers, so it's just an issue that I think everyone can kind of find himself. Topic. That's why I proposed it. What does it mean for us to be? What does it mean for us to have? Can we combine those two things? So, it's more or less the topic.
Do somebody have a question? Santa was saying, passing through the market, what a joy, how much things I totally don't mean.
Uh-huh.
It's a typical story, Santa, and some question?
Do you think it's possible to divide it? I can only do people only to have.
It's a good question. I cannot answer it for myself. For myself, I cannot answer. I heard a lot of opinions, and some people combine it, some people divide it. I mean, you can only be or you can only have, and for myself, I try to find for my life a golden, middle?
Golden average.
Golden average, or whatever, to have and to be happy. That's the word. Like, have plus to be equals happiness, probably. I don't know. For me, my life. So, I cannot answer it. I haven't answered this question for me yet.
Another one? If you are a director of the company and you have,
yes,
and is this a question? If you are, you have something, and that's why you are, yes. Is there a connection to have and to be? Because if you are not,
I think everything depends probably now how you define those things. Because if I'm a director and I do give people jobs, and
I do give them the remuneration that they feed their kids with it. They buy bread, and I'm creating jobs. It's probably more to be, direction more to be value and not to have value.
So you are greater if you give more
opportunities, more happiness to people, yes.
Possibilities to other people.
Okay, so we stop just for 10 minutes to think about the topics we presented, and after we will vote, choosing just one of them, and of course, we will have a discussion about it, with some very, very simple rule that I will explain after 10 minutes. So, you can vote even for all the issues, if you love them all, why not?
But that will be longer.
Oh, yeah.
No, because there is just one of them, so it's not going to be longer.
And what happens if there are kind of the same number of votes for three topics?
Normally it doesn't happen, but we just...
With
people,
okay.
I know we're going to borrow, don't you worry.
Okay.
Don't you worry. Who wants to discuss about marriage? Raise your hands.
No.
Okay.
I want.
One. Who wants to discuss about love and passion?
Me.
Yes, no? Me?
Okay.
Three.
We vote for our.
You vote for who we want, not my name.
I
would
like to add my voice to the first.
Okay, so two. But please not now, just vote what is right moment, because otherwise it's going to be messy. Partnership relation. Discuss about colors of life.
Not me.
Two, three, four. We want to discuss about woman position in different cultures. Four. Four. We want to discuss about working for a corporation. We want to discuss about happiness. Want to discuss about to be or to have?
You have already had the situation when I was talking about.
I have four. I will answer with four.
Yes.
Four.
So yeah. Now let's try once again, and please try to vote just for one. I will give before we start colors of life, woman position, happiness, to be or to
not. No, maybe we choose from those two.
Which two?
Four and four.
But there are four with four.
We have four.
Four.
Yeah.
I believe you. I thought it was three.
No. Colors of life, woman in position, woman position in different cultures. Working on happiness, or to be or to have. Okay? So, who wants to discuss about colors of life? Raise your hands.
Okay. Yeah.
Who wants to discuss about woman position in different cultures? Raise your hands. Who wants to discuss about happiness? Raise your hands. You already won it before.
Oh, sorry.
Oh, okay. I asked it this time to just for one.
Okay.
Okay.
Sorry.
Do you want me to read the quotation? No, no. It's just... Yeah, because now if we go on to...
Okay.
It's going to be infinite. So, we want to discuss about happiness and haven't yet voted for colors of life or position. Who wants to discuss comfort happiness? Okay. Okay, so we'll discuss about woman position in different cultures. You have to start. Ah, well, the rules. The rules are very, 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 very easy. It's really simple. There is a person that starts the conversation. When somebody wants to add something to the conversation, he just raises his hand and I write down his name, okay? And after, I call the people in the order of the hands raising. It's very, very simple. Okay, so of course, try to be a little bit not too long, because otherwise, when it's your turn, usually 15 minutes after, some problem for the other person to remember everything. I suggest you one thing. There we have some little pieces of paper, and to remember everything you want to say, it's good to note something. Because if she speaks, and after she has four persons, and you want to add something, you're going to be the fifth. So you can wait even 20 minutes before you speak. There is going to be better to know what you want to say. Yeah. So, please.
I'm sorry. I think the topic is very interesting. I love it.
Thank you for being here.
And hope to see you again. Sorry, I just had to leave.
Okay.
Something was disturbing.
Because
we are talking about being long somewhere else and to try live in another country, in another culture and be nomad there, or to just be a visitor. And I think we should not relate it to just being a visitor for 2 or 3 weeks, because it's nothing. Yes, it's vacation. And for me, I don't care if I go, for example, to Arabic country. I don't care if Muslim culture is different and treats different women, because I respect that. I don't do anything that could be inappropriate, but I don't feel bad that my country is different and that I expect to be treated in another way. But I think that the most important, the most interesting thing is how do we really have this position, how do we really can believe that when we have to be there for a long time. For example, if we have two cultural marriages or partnerships, or if we have kids with a different culture, men or women, or that we get a job and we are going to spend somewhere, for example, 3 years. Yeah, so for me, this permanence time is the most important thing. Like you said in the very beginning, because you were referring to the time that you spend somewhere for a longer time, yes? And this discussion is really very, very fascinating. And your question was also very, very intriguing. And I think I cannot answer it very, very easily, but how we should behave then, yes? If we go there, and if we spend there time, if we should be adapt, or if we should have something from our own, and how is this referring to the whole population and to our friends or our family or someone that is close to us in this arena, yes. And I was actually very interested, because you were saying very, very important thing, that you couldn't leave or didn't feel bad, didn't feel good with this situation if you were a partner with somebody and you don't share the whole life, like also money, and the culture is that everyone divides everything for himself, yes? How is that? I would like to know if anyone has such experiences from different countries, and so that how the real life looks like. So if anybody could tell me that, like from different cultures, like maybe Western Europe, maybe Asia, maybe something like that. But I would like to hear that also. So this, if you know that from sociological point of view, if you know how women are treated with education, with earning money for themselves. So if anyone has such experiences, I would like you to share it also, because that would help me to create my vision of this subject, yes, of how the woman is treated. I can refer only to Arabic countries because I spend there a lot of time. Not a lot of time, but I talked with people that spend there a lot of time. I mean, been there a few times, and to Scandinavia, but I don't have many other experiences, so that's why I'm so curious.
Actually, I think that the information about it is very helpful. It's kind of, in our meetings with cross-cultural differences, and we have very, very beautiful field of psychology called cross-cultural psychology, and we have plenty of studies being done on different aspects of everyday life of migrants, refugees, women, and men, seniors. I'm just wondering why it's not popular within the population. So, because I think that I don't understand why people are not aware of the fact that there is such a field in psychology, which is in which psychologists and not also psychologists, but different also the different professionals discuss this kind of subjects related to cultural shock and cultural differences and conflicts related to those differences, and how can we actually prepare for this cross-cultural contact when we consider that it will be the longer one. I agree with you that there's a difference between being a tourist and being a migrant, long-term one. I consider myself living in Canada or in France for, I don't know, a couple of years or even a couple of months. Probably it would be a good thing if I prepared myself for differences related to men and family relationships and different things which are probably here for everyone of us. Probably when I'd like to get back to this specific situation with this friend in Germany, probably the good solution would be just explaining that in a calm way that, well, in Poland, to give you information that, well, the need something is from this friend, because I used to be, I don't know, treated in a different way. It's a normal thing that in Poland, my culture, in my native country, you know, the guy and the man is responsible for, I don't know, different things. So to exchange the information, but not to expect that, well, this guy will fulfill my needs and, you know, my customer, Polish customs, but just to ask him how he, maybe we together can work out some kind of solution. So what can we do together about it? So maybe we should, if it's the close person for us, the boyfriend, somebody close, maybe we could, I don't know, work out some kind of agreement, maybe not to compromise a little bit, or what kind of soldier which causes some kind of emotions within us, okay? So that or this or that made me sad or confused because you did something or you didn't something, you did not do something I expected. So, well, that's what I wanted to say.
I had some discussion with my friend from India, mm-hmm. And sometimes I make jokes that he can't understand. When I explain to him that there are the cultural differences, he felt himself that I think that his culture is worse, mm-hmm. in some way, that I, when I
I think that it would be a good thing not to generalize. So we say that you said like that, that people do not listen or they do not understand what we in our intentions, mm-hmm. and probably some of them do not. But there is a huge. I believe that well, I have also some cross-cultural experiences. There's a huge population which is really open-minded and they listen and they find cross-cultural differences as something valuable, interesting. It's the human adventure, it's the, that we differ from each other. It's not necessarily need to, doesn't necessarily need to be a barrier and the reason to fight or you know, to argue is also, I think that it can be the value and the chance for us to open our horizon a little bit wider and to be, you know, to get more open-minded and tolerant at the same time. And so I think that you wanted to share this stuff with me.
You are talking very much about actually communication.
Yes.
Yes, this is the key. But this is also like a possibility to have another topic. Yes, because it's so very connected and that also can be very, very wide. But answering also your question, I think that what I observed and about treating women, both the whole policy of living in other countries, I think everything depends on what country actually it was during colonial times. Like what country was the under what supervision the countries were when we had colonial times. And if, for example, it was Great Britain, it is different. If it was French, it is different. If it was independence, it is also different. And it doesn't matter that they have the same religion, but living in, under supervision of other countries, I really think that shaped the attitude, how men and the whole society has to women. Yes. So. For me, for example, it was very, very strange, however, very fascinating that, for example, women are doing many things in African countries because they want to do it and they don't have to. Things that sometimes we treat that are different from our point of view, or that, for example, are we think that this may actually make us downgrading, but they don't have to do it. They do it because they want to do this, and they feel like that. They want to, for example, stay at home. They stay at home. Yes. For example, in Tunisia, where Tunisia was under French supervision, women get right to education. Very, very early. It was like 100 or 200 years before other countries gave right women to education. And it's not like that everyone is studying there. Yes, there are actually statistically more women studying than in other Arabic countries. But it doesn't change that because they still do what they feel. Or the society that creates the whole spirit of it. So this is like in general answering your question, because the difference is not only about education, it's also about living with partners, about having children and such things. But I think that this education and most important thing to see how the society is developing. they live like in small village houses and have nothing, yes? And they are okay with that. But if there is education, they expect more and they grow with the, and try to make grow the whole society, yes? Because they expect more than they are, how to say that, they develop themselves in the society. Too long, but.
Do we have somebody else? Because here I am alive.
Our country.
study of this Indian woman when they were having a bit what they have. Maybe this Afghanistan women are also we think so because we have our culture and we compare it to
because it is interesting that
we want to actually be European, want to have to implement everywhere the democracy. But there are a lot of countries that you don't need it. They want to have a king, someone who has authority, because only in this way these people can they expect it. Or for government or monarchy or they have monarchy or authority in this country. And I think now about Russia, Putin, such people, they are like Tsar. And although there is not monarchy or but it works in this way still, in my opinion. And maybe these people are happy with it, and for us it's not normal, or we can't stand it. And I can't agree because I think the most the biggest value in the world is freedom. We can say that in Afghanistan they have freedom. For instance, in democratic countries like Canada, they have freedom. They have choice. I guess first it's freedom and then they can have choice. So they have choice. If they want to be like every people in Canada, they do. They can be like everyone. If they don't want, they are Amish. They are Amish. Mm-hmm. They have just to live like 200 years ago. They don't use electricity. They don't use the cars or others. But the point is, you live your life. When you have choice, then you can have your life according to your choice. If in countries like Middle East or there is both, they don't have choice. So that's why I'm saying. It's not that they love it. Maybe, but they don't have choice. So if I was in summer, I would live my life like people there. Huh? Was it my choice? Not really. But I would try to be happy.
Just give you one little provocation is in advertising style of in advertising science they say that to can is must. Okay? So when you have the temptation, the regular temptation on doing something, before or after you will do it. Okay? Like for example, I give you an enormous panel with Coca-Cola all the morning that you wake up, before or after you like Coca-Cola. Because why not? Okay? I'm not forcing you, but why not? Is it possible that somebody just don't want to have choice? Is it possible that, for example, somebody don't want to have freedom?
Of course.
I just leave the provocation on the table and I
but this is also choice. This is also choice.
If you want to
not have choice.
Yeah, but if I force you to have choice, you have a choice.
But
you cannot not have a choice.
No.
I think
if you force me, if you force me to have choice or to not have choice, you force me to do what?
You will answer me.
Most of us were here. We are in Poland.
Hola.
Answer in Poland.
Mm-hmm. This is what I saw at the photos in internet from
Trump. I will tell you a secret. Normally, I can, the people that sit beside me are in the video, mm-hmm. and let's escape from the video.
Yeah.
They don't want to appear in the video. So, yeah, that's why.
Because this is also kind of answer that all the time we meet the difference with drinking men and women. And also in our countries, in our culture, it's kind of from our side, women's side, it's kind of fight to keep a position that what we like to have.
Mother.
Yes, when I was raising my hand, I was actually after you, and this is what I wanted to say. Pretty much very connected because I would like to go back to my former boss who were leading a company, very innovative company. And he said very important thing that I remember that if you take the studies and if you ask people what they want, they will never tell you anything new that they want because they don't know it. So if you really want to make innovation, if you really want to improve something, you must do it and you must show it, and then people will love it or not. But if they don't know it, they will never vote for that. And actually I remember that because it's, for me it's very much referring to what we are talking here about the rights, about freedom, and about what you said, if women have right to choose what she wants. Because if we refer to countries where people, where women doesn't know, where women don't know what could be their life and how could it be different, they will never vote for that. So, like this Afghanistan, yes, for example, if we tell them there is another possibility for you to leave, go to another country, stay there for a while, look how you could be treated. Maybe if she comes back, she will know more. Maybe she says, okay, I want to come back, I want to live like I used to live, or maybe she won't say that. Maybe she says, well, this is the place that I would like to stay because I feel more important here, I'm part of the society and such things. Yes. So, this is the most important thing for me. Like I said, which is also very much connected with education. Because if you educate people, they can also try to improve their lives because they know there is something beyond what they know. Yes, there might be something unknown yet, but they can look farther. And also, I think that people, there are people that they don't want to have a choice, that they want to be left. And I think that that's most of us, for example, even in our country, in our culture, there are people who are leaders who want to manage companies, for example, and there are people who don't want that, who just want to have a good job, do their things from 9 to 5, and go home and do completely different things, yes? So, this is metaphorically speaking, yes, but there are people who don't want to have a choice, but to choose, like you said before, to choose not to have a choice is also a choice.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, and some of this subject about Switzerland, where women didn't want to vote. It was the last country in Europe where women get the right to vote. That was in the 70s. And I can imagine that there are a lot of people who didn't want to choose because it's difficult. us, some people like it to be under rules, under